Dear friends, welcome to another video. In this video, we are going to take a first look at this small e-paper display I just received. There is a lot to cover, so let's get started. Hello guys, I am Nick and welcome to Educates TV, a channel that is all about do-it-yourself electronics projects. In this channel, I share everything about the projects I build to help you develop similar projects or inspire you to start making things because it is easy, fun and creative. Subscribe to the channel now if you don't want to miss any future video. In this video, we are going to use this small e-paper display with Arduino for the first time and talk about its advantages and disadvantages. This display is small, it is 1.5 inch and it is relatively inexpensive. It costs around $15. I will post a link to it in the description below. I can hear you ask, is it really inexpensive? It costs $15 and it is so small. You are right, it is very expensive for a tiny display like this. But you have to take in consideration that it is an e-paper display and e-paper displays are expensive. For example, this 4.3 inch e-paper display I reviewed a few years ago cost around $50. For the first time, we now have access to smaller and cheaper e-paper displays. So we can now build low-cost projects which will use e-paper displays. I am really excited about this. But why to use an e-paper display in a project? E-paper or electronic paper are displays that, unlike traditional LCD or OLED displays, does not emit light but reflect light. It is like the ink on the paper. This characteristic makes e-paper displays very comfortable to read and they have excellent readability under direct sunlight. Another great thing about e-paper displays is that they can hold static text and images for months without electricity. Yes, that's correct. The display can show text and images even when it is off. That makes e-paper displays ideal for low-power projects. Unfortunately, there are some disadvantages as well. The price of e-paper displays is still very high. Another significant disadvantage is that e-paper displays take a lot of time to update, as much as 2 or 3 seconds. So they are only helpful for static text and images and not animations. Let's now see how to use this small e-paper display with Arduino. The display offers a resolution of 200 by 200 pixels, which is great, and it uses the SPI interface. It is a 3.3 volt display, so VCC must be connected to the 3.3 volt output of the Arduino Uno. The other pins of the display are 5 volt tolerant. The next pin is ground and it goes to ground. The third pin is named D-in and it goes to digital pin 11. The fourth pin is clock and it goes to digital pin 13. The fifth pin, CS, goes to digital pin 10. The sixth pin goes to digital pin 9. The seventh pin to digital pin 8 and the last pin to digital pin 7. That's it, we are now ready to load a sketch to the Arduino and watch the display in action. At first, I am going to use the example the company that produces this display offers. As you can see, this demo sketch uses 65% of the RAM memory of the Arduino Uno. The demo sketch displays some graphics and text, but in my opinion, the most important thing that it demonstrates is that it can update part of the display without updating the whole display. This is very useful because updating the whole display takes about 2 seconds and requires a lot of current. In contrast, updating part of the display is fast and it does not require a lot of current. The biggest problem I face with this library is that it only supports a few fonts with very small size. This is the biggest font size we can use. So, if we need to use a bigger font size, we are out of luck since I haven't found any way to design my own fonts yet. There is another library available though which uses the popular Adafruit GFX library which offers many great features like custom fonts. I developed a simple sketch using this library which displays a small poem of Kavafi, my favorite Greek poet. You can find a link to the code of this example in a link in the description below. As you can see, even a small project like this one, which only displays a few lines of text, consumes 94% of the memory of the Arduino Uno. This library needs a lot of memory. So, for bigger projects, we need to use another board with more memory, like the ESP8266, the ESP32, or the STM32 board. Another disadvantage of this display is that the partial screen update does not work very well yet. It seems that the hardware is great, but it needs some time for the software for it to mature. Let's now measure the power consumption of the display. When the display is updating, it needs a lot of current, but I was not able to measure exactly how much with this multimeter. I think it peaks around 7 to 8 milliamps for a few seconds, but this might be wrong. When the display is not updating, it draws around 0.02 milliamps. This is so impressive. This is the display with the lowest power consumption I have ever seen. For comparison, the Nokia 5110 LCD display, my favorite low power display, uses around 0.4 milliamps of current to operate. Of course, the Nokia 5110 does not need 2 seconds to update and it does not require a lot of current to update. But if we want a display that is going to be updated once every few minutes, this e-paper display is the best low power solution we have right now. As a final thought, I think this display is great. The impressive low power consumption it offers will enable us to build impressive battery-powered projects. Imagine projects that can run on batteries for years. How cool is that? There were no displays like this in the past in the market. The big e-paper display that was available so far had an ARM processor in the back to drive it, so it needed around 4 milliamps of current when it was not updating. It was not battery-friendly. Now that we have a really low power e-paper display, we can build some amazing projects. I am going to try to use it with the more advanced ESP32 board soon, and I will post another video, so stay tuned. I would love to hear your opinion about this e-paper display. Are you going to use it in any of your projects? Do you think it is expensive for what it offers? Please post your ideas in the comment section below. I love reading your thoughts. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribe. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects twice a month. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things, anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. I will see you in the next video.